So it's Thursday and I have been chosen to be on the girls' football team. And I am super, super excited because the tournament's today. But I'm a little bit nervous because I don't know much about football. But we're going to be walking down to a park and we're going to be going against another school. So I'm just going to go downstairs, have my breakfast, and then I'll get off to school.
Good luck for later, Elsie.
Thanks, Mum. Bye.
All right, have a nice day. Bye.
Good morning, Tyra fam. So it actually is quite a nice day outside. I checked the weather forecast and it is the only nice day for the rest of the week. So fingers crossed it stays nice for Elsie's football match. She was a bit worried because she was like, Mum, I don't know how to play it, but I was picked because I'm really good at gymnastics. So I know she's going to do well. I just said to her, like, kick the ball into the opponent's goal. That's it. Basics. So yeah, it's about 11:30 now. Jude is at the boxing gym. Jean is just finishing up with her maths. Max and Olive are upstairs. And today actually marks the third day of Iris being off school. She came down with a sick bug on Tuesday in the night, literally like crying in pain. It was like really bad pain and she was vomiting. Then she vomited all the day as well. And then, so we kept her off that day and the next day. And then she didn't eat anything yesterday at all. So I really didn't want to send her in feeling really weak and tired. So I've kept her off today, but here she is. Say hello, Iris.
Hi.
How are you feeling?
Wow, this is going to be fun. Let's try another one. Let's
not
see.
Hello.
This looks like
not a better. Heart.
Not better yet. No, so she's just on her iPad, just chilling in the corner with some blankets. But she is up and she is dressed. I wanted to just make her feel a bit better. But yeah, so she's off today and probably back tomorrow, as long as I can feed her up with some good nutrition today. But the only thing she actually wanted this morning was crisps. And I know that's really bad, but sometimes after you've been sick, I think it's really important to listen to your body, like to replenish the salts or whatever else that your body is like crying out for. And she could probably have got it from somewhere else, but she really felt like that. So I gave her some crisps. Don't judge. This morning I have just been catching up on housework. My washing basket, guys, is at an all-time low. Hola, I'm super proud of myself because as you can imagine, we have so much laundry. I could literally hire somebody to have a full-time job in this house just to handle the laundry. It is insane. Anyway, so for the rest of the day, I have tried to be really organized and write everything down in my diary. So we do have to take Jude to his friend Richie, who lives up in Alton. And I'm really excited about this because there is an Aldi in Alton. And lots of you guys have told me that there are some great vegan options there. But I haven't never really like been able to justify like the 30 minutes travel to get there. But because we are going there anyway to drop Jude off, I'm really excited to go in there if we get enough time to pick up a few bits and have a look around. So when I pick up Elsie from school today, it's a bit later than usual. It's going to be 4:20, and then she has to go straight on to choir at 4:45. So I'm hoping she's not too muddy from that. Max then has football from 6 until 7. The reason I'm dropping off Jude at Richie's is because they are doing a trial for tumbling tonight. It's Jude really, really wants to learn all these tricks and flips and things, and what better way than in a safe, controlled environment. That is from 7 until 9, so he'll get dropped off at around 2:30, spend the day with his friend, and then his dad will take them to the tumble class. So I'm not expecting him home until at least 9:15. I think that is it. But Leah, I'm feeling super organised. Hopefully everything goes to plan.
Hi guys! Oh, sick in my bed, so I go in Max's bed, and then I've been sick in Max's bed. Then Daddy brings me downstairs, and I was sick like 5 times or 6 times. So that's really, really strange. No one's sick like that before, but I'm just relaxing and I'm going to school tomorrow, guys.
Ladybugs, look, Mummy's bought you some strawberries. Are you gonna share them? Oh, the hamster's eating the strawberries. Oh, the hamsters have got socks on their backs.
Yeah.
Did you do that, Iris?
Yeah, I helped pull it.
That's really clever. They've both got them on. So eat your strawberries, okay? Mummy's trying to fix you. Trying to get you back healthy again. And strong. Lots of energy, yeah? So you can go to school tomorrow.
And yummy.
Yeah, and yummy juice. It's not yuck, it's strawberries. What do you like then, Olive? What do you like? What do you like to eat? Yeah, well, what does Olive like to eat?
Burger.
No.
You don't want to eat burger.
I know she doesn't. She's fibbing, isn't she?
No, I like biscuits.
Biscuits, yeah. You do like biscuits, that's the truth. But you usually eat strawberries as well.
Watching about the solar system, it was really fun, and Jupiter has over 67 moons.
Yes.
That's a lot of moons compared to Earth. Earth only has one moon. One? 67. And Venus is the most hottest planet. I thought it was going to be Mercury because it's the closest to the sun, but it's actually Venus. That's a lot weird, isn't it?
Mum has just ordered these shoes for me, and I'm so happy because these shoes, I love them so, so much. And I'm also really, really happy because these are fake leather, which is really, really good because obviously I do not want leather shoes, and they are on offer. When I first found these shoes, they didn't have my size, which, like, literally it was only my size that wasn't there, and now my size has came back and they're on offer, so we have ordered them. And I am just so, so happy, and I cannot wait for them to come. They're just, I just so happy. I was searching for like ages to find shoes like that. And yeah, now I'm just going to be eating these two spicy burgers because, guys, I'm starving. And I think Mum is going to be going to Aldi soon, and I really, really wanted to go because the last time I went to Aldi was in Australia, and that was like so long ago. But I can't go because I have Spanish at 2:30 today. So I'm going to be left at home, which is actually going to be quite nice because, guys, those two over there have been screaming and fighting and throwing and smashing. Hi! But yeah, guys, it's going to be so much more peaceful and quiet without them. All you're looking at, Jude, is the sweets. What sweets you can get. Mints and sweets and chocolate. Thank you. What is it?
It's a melon.
It's a melon. Do you want me to buy it?
Yeah.
Come on then, pass it to Mummy.
It's really big.
It is. You're funny.
I can't see. Hi.
Hi, look, I found some smoothies.
Yeah. Oh, yay. Can I drink one now?
In a minute, and there's some frozen berries.
Mommy's party. Ma! Stop it, Ma!
I found some frozen blueberries and some frozen raspberries.
Mummy! Oh, did you get one?
Judas found these dark chocolate bunnies, guys, like Easter ones, and they are vegan, so I'm probably going to get
bunny,
some of those.
Bunny.
Yeah, we don't have. How about a big bunny?
Mama, can I hold one?
A big bunny?
Yeah, can I bring it?
Yeah, you can.
Oh, it's chocolate.
Mama,
can
I eat
get
it?
Six. Not right now.
I'll bring it
for Easter.
I
yeah.
Bunny.
That's bunny. A baby bunny. We're going to get big bunnies.
No. Ollie wouldn't.
Ollie, that one's not vegan. So that's why we have to get the big bunnies, okay?
No.
Give one, Jude, give her one so she can put it in. Good girl.
Big bunny, that's so delicious. Bunny likes me.
Bunny does like me. Yeah, you can. It might melt though. So we are out of Aldi, guys, and overall, I wasn't that impressed. Maybe I just didn't know what I was looking for, or the fact that I was with the children, and obviously that everything gets a bit like fraught when you're with children in a supermarket. But I was really happy. As I was at the checkout, I found these hike bars. Very cheap, 49p, and they seem very similar to the chocolate Trek bars that I get for the children for their packed lunch, but a lot cheaper. So excited to give these a go. The children talked me into lots of sweeties, And yeah, chocolate bunnies. Are you happy with that?
And we need Eden once.
What happened?
Ollie hurt herself.
Oopsie daisy, Olive's hurt herself. What did she, oh, she was standing up. Are you okay, princess? Come here and I'll kiss your head. Oh, you want me to kiss it there? Okay. That better?
Yeah.
Okay.
Mum's just taken me to Richard's house, but we've got lost.
Yeah, it's because I've never come out of that shop before, and now I'm on a country lane.
Daddy did the same, and Daddy had to go all the way back to our house and then come back.
Yeah.
Dad got lost.
Well, where was he taking you?
He was taking me to Richard's house, but there was a diversion.
Right, there's another sign for Ogden, so I'm going to follow that one back that way, and then I might know where I am.
No!
It's okay. Are you arguing over the chockey?
I want to hold Ollie, and Ollie want to hold her.
You both want to hold the chockey? You don't need to cry, okay? We can share it. We've got plenty of chockey to go around, haven't we? Olive, your whole mouth is full of chockey. How was that chocolate on your tummy?
A little bit sick.
Yeah, I don't think your tummy's ready for chocky just yet, is it?
Yeah.
Not yet. It's all right.
All gone.
We're going to be
it's
home in a minute.
It's all gone.
Olive, you're eating way too much chocky.
Guys, I've been sick. Oh, Mum, I'm really, really sorry.
No, you don't need to be sorry. It's not your fault.
It is my fault.
Hello.
The car.
It's okay, it's not your fault, darling. It's not your fault that you're sick, is it? I can't even show you what is going on. What does the car look like, Iris?
A big, sick.
A big, sicky puddle.
Yeah.
And how are you feeling now? Do you feel a bit better now you've been sick?
I might be sick again.
You need a bath. You need to go and get in the bath.
Why?
Get all cleaned up, okay?
This is my worst day ever getting sick.
Iris is now in the bath, but I don't know about you guys, but seeing sick, smelling sick, honestly, I think because I was so sick during my pregnancies, like horrifically, I had a condition called hyperemesis. It brings back so many like torturous memories for me, and I instantly start to feel waves of nausea. It's just like horrific. But she's getting all cleaned up now. But I realized as we took Olive out of her car seat that she had wet the car seat. So she is all soaking wet as well. So we need to get her in the bath. Today I have tried to be so organized, so like on top of my game, but things like this you just cannot help. You cannot help that your child wheezes in the car. You cannot help that another child is sick. You cannot help that another child needs picking up from school. And you just have to stay positive. You just have to be like, hey ho. So I'm finally getting a chance to talk to you about how football went.
It was really, really good. We went like 2 or 3 matches.
Yeah.
And I was in goal twice. And
did
I,
like, you want to be in goal?
Not really. Like at first I was like, yeah, I want to be in goal.
And then you realise it's not that
then
fun.
Then I saw some girls being in goal and I was like, I don't really want to be in it. But yeah. I had to because I signed up to be in goal.
Yeah.
But I let 2 goals in and I saved one. But when I saved it, like it went on my leg and I got like a little brace.
It hurts. The balls are like hard and heavy. Yeah.
It's really rough football. I was like the smallest on the pitch as well.
Exactly.
It's one of the girls in year 6, it's year 6 and year 5, she said, I'm going to call you Midge Elsie.
Aww, it's not your fault,
mind.
Is it?
Yeah.
Did you like it though? Do you like the game of football?
Yeah.
How did your team do then in the whole tournament? Where did you come?
We came 4th, which is last.
High five, girlfriend. That's good. Iris is now on the sofa with blankets. She's all bathed. And her and Olive are now sitting down, about to watch. Can you guess?
Boss Baby.
I was just about to get Jean to try one of these hike bars that I showed you earlier. And I was just double checking the ingredients because I always have to triple check just to be sure. And they have got cashew nuts in. Now, Elsie is airborne to cashew nuts, like airborne allergic.
Like the same room as her.
Yeah, you can't.
Just has an allergic reaction.
So now all of these are completely useless unless like dad takes them to work.
Yeah.
Or I give them to my mum or someone like that, as long as they're not coming round my house that day or eating in my house.
Didn't they have the shoes involved?
They did.
How could you not see
I didn't see it. It was the last ingredient because I don't know. I don't know. So yeah. I just dropped off Elsie to choir in my sick and wee infested car. Oh, I am so thankful that dad will do this for me because I just can't do it. I'd rather like blow the car up and never have a car again than have to clean that. I'm just about to make Olive a smoothie because although I will give her some dinner, she is very unlikely to eat it because, as I've said before, the girl lives on like air and a few bits and bobs. So I'm going to make a banana strawberries. These are from earlier. Frozen raspberries that I picked up today and date smoothie, medjool dates. And these are the soups I've got, guys. I've got this cauliflower, chickpea and turmeric one. Carrot, butternut, squash and ginger, and fragrant Thai carrot. I'm gonna put some corn on, some other veggies, and the bread there. I am also going to add some sunflower seeds and some pumpkin seeds for those healthy fats though. Yay, get in there. This right here is what keeps Olive like functioning. She doesn't eat anything else. Oh, she does eat porridge in the morning. Porridge in the morning and a smoothie and then dribs and drabs. But she's growing.
Hey guys! So I just got back from choir because my voice is amazing, that's why I go. And I'm still from tank drink. Like a bridge over troubled water. I'm raining down like a bridge over troubled water. I'm raining down. So that's the song. It's literally so amazing. It's like my favorite song out of all of them. There's so many. I could probably sing them all to you, but I would be wasting my time. So, yeah, guys.
These two have been playing together really nicely for a while now. And Jean and Elsie have just finished their dinner and Elsie has put on hairspray. It's a school night, Elsie. You gotta go to bed.
Hi.
How was it?
It was fun.
Was you cold?
No, I was
like, it's not that cold today, is it? I'm really hot now.
I've got most of the time just saving every shot.
Was you?
Yeah.
You're the man. You hungry?
Yeah, what's for dinner?
Soup. Iris just had like a small bit of soy milk and now her tummy is grumbling and in pain again, isn't it, baby? I might give her some painkiller. I don't often give my children like medication for like taking their temperature down or anything because I'm a strong believer in burning out the problem. But helping them to fight it themselves. But when you're in pain, I definitely think that's not a nice thing. And gastro pain, I've had it myself, is awful. I've actually found that painkiller doesn't help that much either, to be honest, for gastro pain. Do you want something to take the pain away? Do you think you need it?
Yeah.
Yeah? Oh, I'm so sorry, baby. Give me a hug.
I'm gonna give me some medicine.
Yeah, I'll get you some medicine. Then we're gonna read a story. We're going to read a story called I Want That. Yeah?
Yeah.
I think it's safe to say that Iris will not be going to school tomorrow. So literally, you've only been to school for one day. You only went on Monday, didn't you?
Yeah.
And then you got sick.
I'm not going to school for 4 days now.
Yeah. Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, that's today, and then tomorrow, Friday. And then it's the weekend, Saturday and Sunday. So you're going to have lots of days off and then you'll be really ready and healthy and strong to go back on Monday, yeah? Yeah? I'll go and get you some painkiller. Is that okay? Hope that makes you feel better.
I'm going to call it in.
Right, should we read our story?
Yeah.
Okay. Come and snuggle with Mama.
Hello, I'm Big Dave.
And I'm Little Dave.
And I'm Baby Dave.
Yeah, we're all Dave.
Yeah.
Dave.
It is now 8:10. Both girls are in bed. Jude isn't going to get home till 9:15, so I'm going to... Yeah, he doesn't finish. He doesn't finish his class until 9, and then they've got to drive back here. So I will have to let you know tomorrow how he got on, if he likes it, if he's going to continue going. Tomorrow morning, me and Olive are doing something super exciting and special, but I will wait until tomorrow to reveal that to you.
I think I know it is.
Yeah, it's really, really exciting. You will wait and see.
I think I know.
Yeah, else you know because you helped me with it a little bit. But yeah, can't wait to share it with you guys.
Oh.
Thank you so much for watching another one of our vlogs, and we will see you next time. Bye, guys.
Bye, guys.
Bye, guys.
Don't forget to like, subscribe, thumbs up, leave a comment, like share it with your mates. Tell them to come and join the Tyra fam. And yeah, just like be our mate. We love you all so much, don't we?
Yeah, mate.
Bye, guys.
Bye.
Bye, guys. Turn down for what?